We are going also to greet our brethren in Putan, Campos. Praise God with Sister Arlene. Hallelujah. Follow up your people there. Send the link and praise God. You need, okay, DB Campos also. Discovery Campos with, praise God, our brethren there. Okay, si Margie Giselle, sabi niya, good morning. Praise the Lord, Sister Feli Padilla, Unit 9. Praise God. God bless, God bless, God bless. Praise God. Hallelujah. And we are going also to greet our brethren in Macau. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We greet you in the name of the Lord. Praise God. Parami na ng parami, mga kapatid. And we are going also to greet our brethren in the Philippines, your families. Sister okay, Sister Arlene Valentin is present. Hallelujah. Sister Katrina, the youth department. Praise God. Come on, Carl, Kim, where are you? Praise God. Hallelujah. Type there, present. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. I will not start here if you are not there. Okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So at this time, praise God, we have lots of victory reports and prayer requests. Praise God. But at this time, it's time to preach the word of the Lord. And I'm so happy, praise God, that the Lord had given me once again, praise God, this opportunity, January 17, 2021, hallelujah, to minister to you the word of the Lord. We will continue to feed you with spiritual food. Praise God, hallelujah, we will continue, praise God, our ministry, our job description here, our, praise God, answer to the call of God to preach the word and to teach His word. And I pray, hallelujah, that you just open your heart and the Lord will reveal, praise God, through the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And wherever you are right now, praise God, the power and the presence of the Lord will touch you. Praise God, the presence of the Lord will touch you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Brother GP is watching also. The men's department, welcome. Hallelujah. Brother Radmar, and you can put the names in the comment section there, FB accounts, so that maybe others are still sleeping, you know. But hey, hello, this is Sunday. Maybe others are still, fixing the breakfast of their wards, praise God, or maybe helping their employer, praise God. And actually, most of the time, it's easy to say to review the video, but actually, praise God, it's better that you can join and you can follow the live stream, praise God, because, reviewing videos like this, especially if you, praise God, in this busy time, sometimes it's impossible to do. But anyway, praise God, the Lord will bless us all. And without any further delay, praise God, hallelujah, we will read the scripture and after that, praise God, we will pray unto the Lord. And just find a place, praise God, that you are comfortable with your mobile. Praise God, find a place, praise God, in which there is no, praise God, so much distraction. Praise God, maybe you are outside since this is your day off. But, okay, let us do this, praise God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shall we open our Bible in the book of Isaiah, praise God, chapter 1, verse 18. Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 18. A very familiar part of the scripture. Praise God, hallelujah. And I will read this. Come now and let us reason together. Praise God. Can you say, let us reason together? Hallelujah. I cannot hear you. Saith the Lord, do your sins be as scarlet. Scarlet is a red color. Okay, these shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, praise God, these shall be as wool. Hallelujah. Praise God. This morning, God is challenging everybody, every one of us, to come to Him, praise God, and let us reason together. I will bring to you a subject entitled, at the meeting point. At the meeting point. Hallelujah. May the Lord will bless us. Praise God for reading And as you are watching, praise God, and following it through your Bible, shall we bow down our head and let us pray. Holy One of Israel, thank you, God. What a beautiful morning that you have given to us. Lord, thank you for this day off of our brethren of New Life Fellowship and even the hallelujah with the like of faith, praise God, from other churches who are watching right now. I pray, O God, that you will, praise God, receive our praise. You will receive our prayer. Hallelujah. And you will pour out your spirit to all the hearts, praise God, especially to those who are lonely, praise God, who are suffering, God. In this morning, God, I pray, God, that the word will become so alive. Your word, God, hallelujah, will become a light, O Lord Jesus, that will lead us into the way, praise God, of peace and understanding and salvation. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I declare healing to those who are watching with pain in their body. Hallelujah, I send healing in the name of the Lord Jesus. And to those who are confused, O God, that have battled with fear, hallelujah, and doubt, in the name of Jesus, I cut off all sources of unbelief, all sources of doubt. I deprive the voice of doubt, hallelujah. I shut down all the arguments, hallelujah, in their mind, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Let faith will arise, O God, this morning, while I share, O God, thy word. I declare a miracle, O God, in their life, peace in their family, O God, harmony in their group and units, in the name of the Lord, God, that even in this online live stream, they can feel your holy presence. They will speak in tongues as the Spirit will give the utterance. Oh, hallelujah, Lord, all of us this morning who are present in this live stream, we are before your presence, God. We are now in your presence, and I pray your blessing will be upon your people. Guide me, O Lord, and bless my lips, O Lord. Hallelujah, by the power and the fire of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, that all of us this morning, hallelujah, can meet at that meeting point where you are waiting, O God, hallelujah, to release, hallelujah, your forgiveness, your blessing, hallelujah, to release your peace and everything, God, that you have prepared for your people that we cannot imagine, O God, hallelujah. Thank you so much, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name I pray, amen and amen and amen and amen. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Praise God. At the meeting point, praise God. Hallelujah. At New Life, praise God Fellowship. Hallelujah. We have a restaurant before, just across the street in the Hong Kong Plaza. The name of that restaurant is Meeting Point. Praise God. But unfortunately, because of this pandemic, because of this COVID-19, it was closed. Praise God. Hallelujah. How many times together with the staff and some of the coordinators invited us at this restaurant, the name of this place was The Meeting Point. Praise God. The word meeting point, hallelujah, the Cambridge Dictionary defined that it is a place or an area in which people can meet and talk together. Praise God. That's a meeting point. And if you know, if you can Google, praise God, if you can, actually you can search it, praise God, there is a place in the heavily demilitarized zone, praise God, the heavily guarded border in the world, praise God, in North Korea, between North and the South Korea, praise God, there is a small village, praise God, the name Pamunjun. Praise God. That's the name of the small village, Pamunjun. Pamunjun is also known, praise God, as Pamunjum. It is located in Kaohsiung, North Hwanghae Province in North Korea. It is a small village just north of the de facto border of the North and the South, where in 1953, it was the meeting point, hallelujah, of the Korean Armistice Agreement that pushed the Korean War. And the Korean War was signed for a truce, and that building where the armistice was signed still stands today. That was the meeting point. Pamunjun is it's a name. It is often used also as a metonym for the joint security area, where discussions between North and South Korea still take place in the blue buildings that straddle the military demarcation line. As such, it is considered one of the last vestiges of the Cold War. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. In that area, in Panmunjom, you can see that in 2018, it was a desire of some leaders to have a reunification of the Korean Peninsula. So the Supreme Leader of the North and the President of the South in April 27, 2018, during the 2018 Inter-Korean Summit, they meet, praise God, in that what they called the Peace House. It was the meeting point between the North and the South in what they called the Peace House in the joint security area. And in that meeting point, both of their hands were raised up. A declaration that they tried. They called it Panmunjom Declaration for Peace, Prosperity and Reunification of the Korean Peninsula at the meeting point. So at that meeting point, these two opposing countries talk and they raise their hands and they tried to iron out things that their differences, but unfortunately until now, praise God, they are still technically at war. Praise the Lord. So this morning, I'm going to bring you a subject in the Bible at the meeting point. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, house trends that God invites people to come to Him at that meeting point. House trends, praise God, that the Almighty God invites people to come to Him in that particular meeting point to discuss something, to settle something, praise God, so that you can raise your hands in peace and joy with the presence, hallelujah, of the Lord. Now, one would think that we would be knocking on His door when God invited us, okay, come to me. Praise God, and let us reason together. God seek before us before we seek Him. Praise God, we must remember it in the book of Luke, in the Gospel of Luke, the Bible tells us that for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. God is seeking us before we are seeking Him. In the book of Isaiah, there was a challenge. Hallelujah. God is inviting people at that meeting point, even though, praise God, they are not qualified, so to speak, because God was talking about their sins and their rebellious life. But God said, anyway, come. I can make your sin, I can make your life, praise God, as white as snow. Now, praise God, Isaiah called to invite people, praise God. This invitation is very unique, praise God. Because Isaiah called to invite people to come and to be clean. Praise God. I repeat it again. To come and to be clean. Isaiah called to invite people to come and be clean at that meeting point. Praise God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. A wonderful invitation. Praise God. It is a wonderful invitation. You know, when North and South Korea, praise God, will have a joint meeting in that Peace House, all the media around the world, praise God, will go there because it would be historic, it would be rare, praise God, that the two leaders, the two governments will meet each other. But here this morning, praise God, hallelujah, angels are watching in heaven. If there would be people that would respond to the challenge of God, come to me and you will be clean at this meeting point. And we know in the New Testament that if there's one soul that will repent, there would be thousands and thousands of angels rejoicing in heaven for just one soul, hallelujah, that can come at that meeting point. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. It is a wonderful invitation. an invitation that is still being extended today, not just in the time of Prophet Isaiah, but even today, God is still extending this invitation to come and be clean at that meeting point. So what's this invitation all about? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Number one, praise God, this is an invitation to reason at an unreasonable time. Did you see that? Did you hear me? Praise God. God set a meeting point for the people of Israel. Hallelujah. He said, come and let us reason together. Praise God. An invitation to reason at an unreasonable time. Come now and let us reason together. Isaiah's nation was in deep, deep trouble. The people had rebelled against the Lord. The people had rebelled against the Lord. Now, how can God invite rebellious people? Hallelujah. How can God offer, praise God, that, okay, let us reason together. Let us talk. Let us sit down. Let us settle this thing. Praise God. Hallelujah. He said, hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for the Lord had spoken. I have nourished and brought up children, and they have rebelled against me. Hallelujah. What a sad verse. God nourished. God supplied. God protected the people of Israel. But at the end of the day, all of them rebelled against him. Hallelujah. Praise God. They choose not to think about God. They choose not to even think, praise God, about the God of their fathers. God said, the ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Israel, hallelujah, but Israel do not know. My people do not even consider, do not even think, hallelujah, of the goodness that I have done to them. They had not even imagined, praise God, my covering. Praise God, my grace to them. And God said, the ox knoweth his owner. It seems that the people of Israel did not even recognize anymore who is their great shepherd. The people of Israel lost, hallelujah. They could never identify anymore who is the true God, because their nation has been flooded with idolatry. They rebelled against the Lord, hallelujah. But still, God has an invitation. Praise God, he said, let us reason in this unreasonable time. Hallelujah. Sin was rampant. Corruption was everywhere. Praise God, you can read with me in verse 4. And you can, praise God, picture out the nation of Israel. God said, a sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel to anger. They are gone away backward. This is, hallelujah, recorded in Isaiah for us in this generation. Praise God, hallelujah, that we would not follow this path. Hallelujah, instead, we would put the word in our heart and obey it. Hallelujah, we will put in our mind, in our spirit, praise God, to serve Him. That is why even in the time of Isaiah, praise God, God told Isaiah, let the people come to me. Let us reason. Let us settle this together once and for all. Even though, praise God, this is an unreasonable time, for the sin was rampant. Corruption is everywhere. These wayward ones have not responded to chastening. Praise God, these rebellious people did not even respond, praise God, to the rebuke and chastening of the Lord. Why should ye be stricken anymore? God said, ye will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick and the whole heart faint. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. If you can just picture out right now the spiritual condition of this, hallelujah, Jewish people, they are out of tune, hallelujah. They gone backward what God said, hallelujah. And God said, why you are still waiting for another punishment? why you should be stricken anymore? Praise God. These people did not even respond. Hallelujah. Praise God. They did not even respond to the chastening of God. I remember before when I was a child, praise God, when I commit mistake and my mother will just spank me at the back and I will just laugh at it. Praise God. Remember, when I was a child, praise God, there was a time that I was very naughty. Praise God. Hallelujah. When my mother spanked me with brooms, you know, one stick of broom. Not one stick, the whole broom. Praise God. Sa Bisaya, pahangtod nga naupos na lang ang silhig. Praise God. I don't know how to translate it in English. Praise God. Hallelujah. She beat me so hard. Hallelujah. Why? Because the first time that she beat me, I just laughed as if I did not respond to the chastening. And the more I did not respond, the more she get angry. Praise God. This is what God is telling to the people of Israel. I already chasten you. I already sent and stricken you. And you did not respond. You're just smiling. And God became more and more angry because there was no response to the, praise God, to the rebuke or to the, should I say, praise God, the word is to the chastening. Praise God of God. To the correction of God. They just laughed. They just paid no attention of it. Hallelujah. But still God said, come to me and let us settle this together once and for all. Hallelujah. They were a sin-sick people. Hallelujah. That's what verse 6 said. From the head, it was sick. Their heart painted. When it comes to the subject of holiness, they don't like. When it comes to the subject of righteousness, praise God, their head cannot comprehend because their head is sick. Praise God. Hallelujah. From the sole of the foot, even to the head, there is no soundness in it. Can you picture out with me, praise God, with these verses? Hallelujah. They are the people of God. But yet, what happened to them? They gone backward. They turn away from the presence of God. But wounds and bruises, putrefying sore, they have not been closed, neither bound up, neither mollified with ointment. That is the description that God gave to Isaiah to the whole nation of Israel. Hallelujah. They are going backward. They're more than backslidden. Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh, but God said, I still invite you. God said, still come to the meeting point and let us settle these things together at once so that you can raise your hand and I can raise your hand also in peace. Hallelujah. That is the desire of God. Hallelujah. For the lost. That is the desire of God for all the sinners. Oh, at that meeting point, there is revival. At that meeting point, praise God, when one will decide to turn back to God and say, Lord, forgive me, God will accept you. Hallelujah. Crime and violence characterized the age in the time of Isaiah. Rebellion did not make sense in light of God's blessings. Still, God invited them to come to Him and reason together. What a love! Did you hear me? What a love from heaven! What a great love of God, the Maker, praise God, of heaven, that even though the whole nation, hallelujah, is sinful and being laden with iniquity, praise God, if you can just describe and you can, praise God, you can just repeat the words there, praise God, in your own Bible, and you will just realize, hallelujah, how prostrated was God to them. But yet, hallelujah, hallelujah, He is God. His nature remained, hallelujah, with mercy. His nature remains with great, hallelujah, kindness and compassion to all the people. And this invitation extended even this morning to all the people watching me right now. Hallelujah, praise God. Whether you are baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost or not, I will tell you, let us go together at once at that meeting point. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. What a love. What a love. Hallelujah. Praise God. What is this invitation at that meeting all about? An invitation from God at an ungodly time. Hallelujah. It is an invitation of God to this meeting point at the moment that the whole nation is very far, far away from Him. An invitation from God at an ungodly time. See, When Jesus came to this world, He already told us. He came to seek and to save that which was lost. It was not the lost who seek Him. How can the lost, how can those sheep that are being astray, hallelujah, could go home by itself? The shepherd is looking for the stray sheep, hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord, and you are that sheep, and I am that sheep, hallelujah. And He found us. He seek us first. Praise God, because we meet Him at the meeting point. I will tell you, church, praise God, the source of this invitation to come at the meeting point is, saith the Lord, Isaiah said. Thus saith the Lord. It was the Lord Himself who extended this invitation of this ungodly time. God called to those who had forsaken Him. Praise God. If you are going to look at verse 4, God is calling to those people who are forsaking Him. To those people who gone away backward. Praise God. Hallelujah. People who have grieved and provoked His Holy Spirit. These people reminded Isaiah of Sodom and Gomorrah. Praise God. Isaiah wrote these words. Except the Lord of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom and we should have been like Gomorrah. Look at, praise God, the sin of the whole country. We know the story of Sodom and Gomorrah. But God told Isaiah, Isaiah said, except the Lord of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom and we should have been like unto Gomorrah. What a sinful generation in the time, hallelujah, Isaiah. And hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom, give ear unto the law of our God, ye people of Gomorrah. Prophet Isaiah addressed the people of Israel, hallelujah, rulers of Sodom, people of Gomorrah. Praise God. I have read the whole book of Lamentations. Praise God. And I have come this particular verse, why it was called Lamentations. When Jeremiah wept over the city, praise God, of Jerusalem and all Judea and all the Israelite, praise God, that were being captive. Hallelujah. He said in Lamentations chapter 4 verse 6, for the punishment of the iniquity of the daughter of my people is greater than the punishment of the sin of Sodom that was overthrown as in a moment and no hands stayed on her. Do you know what happened when, if you're going to read the book of Lamentation? Hallelujah. When Nebuchadnezzar invaded the land, praise God, there was a great famine. Children on the streets, hallelujah, are crying. Their skins become black because they have no food to eat until they die. Hallelujah, that was a slow death for the people of Jerusalem. And Jeremiah said, the punishment of the iniquity of the daughter of my people, referring to the whole nation of Israel, is greater than the punishment of sin in Sodom. Did you see the magnitude, hallelujah, of their sin? Their punishment is greater. Look at that line. Their punishment is greater, hallelujah, than the punishment of the sin of Sodom, hallelujah, that was overthrown as in a moment and no hands stayed on her. When God rained down the fire from heaven, it was just a moment. It was just few seconds and all people died. It was just like a nuclear bomb. Praise God that all people died except Lot and his family. Praise God. Or two daughters, should I say. It was just for a moment. That's what Jeremiah said. When God punished and judged Sodom and Gomorrah because of their sin, it was just a moment and no hands stayed. All came to dust and ashes. But what happened when God punished Israel? Praise God. It was a slow death. Praise God. If you will look, I will challenge you to read the book, whole book of Lamentations. You will find out, hallelujah, how the people died, how their women and their virgins and their princes died on the streets, hallelujah, for no food for several days, and they died in hunger, praise God, slowly and slowly and slowly. And Jeremiah said, the punishment of Sodom is better than the punishment of my daughter, of my people. Hallelujah. But yet, in this ungodly time, in the time of Jeremiah, still God invites them. Would you please come at once and let us settle this so that I will not strike you again? Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of God. Why people in this world are hard, their heart is so hard. They're so much pride, hallelujah, of who they are, praise God. But it's time for us to realize, hallelujah, that if we just come into the presence of God and humbled ourselves, we can settle it at once at the feet of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. And Isaiah said, there are only a few righteous one skip from the destruction. There are only few remnants. Kunti lang mga kapatid. There are only few who survive the punishment of God. That is why Isaiah said, there are only few remnants. Hallelujah. That was there. If you will read in the book of Lamentations, that small remnant, Sister Malo, praise God, that's what Jeremiah said. Hallelujah, because of the mercies of God. His mercies are new every morning. If not, all of us are already consumed. Hallelujah. I will read to you Ezekiel. Praise God, hallelujah. Who are the people? Praise God, the remnants who remain, who survived the punishment of God. Because they came to God, hallelujah, and they settled everything. It shall be for the priests that are sanctified of the sons of Zadok, which have kept my charge, which went not astray when the children of Israel went astray, as the Levite went astray. Hallelujah, Jesus. This verse during the time of Ezekiel are the only remnants who remain alive when God punished the whole land of Israel because they refused, hallelujah, to come at that meeting point. Hallelujah, and Ezekiel, in his vision of how God distributed the land. Listen to me carefully. Maybe some of you did not read this particular chapter. This is a vision of Ezekiel. A vision, hallelujah, that God gave to Ezekiel to distribute the land, praise God, of Israel to the 12 tribes. You know what happened? The tribe of Dan, God put it to the farthest, hallelujah, from the temple. The tribe of Dan, he put it into the farthest part of the north. And God only gave one city in the tribe of Dan. Do you know why God put the tribe of Dan, praise God, the farthest from the temple, the farthest from the tabernacle, the farthest from where, hallelujah, the Ark of the Covenant was? In this vision, praise God, hallelujah, it was explained, the tribe of Dan was put in the farthest, and he was just given only one city because he rebelled against God to idolatry. Praise God. The tribe of Dan rebelled God through idolatry. And because of that, in this vision, God put him, hallelujah, to the farthest part of the country, very far from the tabernacle, very far from the center of his activity, very far from the presence of God. If we rebelled against God, hallelujah, God will put you so far from the tabernacle that what is what happened, praise God, in the book. Praise God, or in the tribe, should I say, the tribe of Dan. But Ezekiel said, the tabernacle, praise God, should be given. It shall be, you can read it shall be for the priest that are sanctified of the sons of Zadok. Because there are many priests also who backslid. There are many pastors also who turn away, hallelujah, from the truth. Praise God. And that is why Ezekiel, in this vision, God gives to him, it shall be for the priests that are sanctified of the sons of Zadok, which have kept my charge, which went not astray when the children of Israel went astray, as the Levites went astray. Do you know the tribe of Levi? The tribe of Levi should serve the tabernacle. They are the tribe which produces the priest. The priesthood belong to the Levites. But what happened? Hallelujah. Because of so much iniquity of the land, praise God, the Levite also went astray. The tribe of Levi went astray. The whole nation, the children of Israel, went astray. But there are still priests who remain, who continue to keep the charge of the Lord. There are still people who remain faithful, hallelujah, to the Lord. There are still people who remain faithful, hallelujah, who still believe in the promise of God, even in the midst, hallelujah, of troubles of their country, in the midst of the ravaging army, hallelujah, Babylon. There are still people who stand, hallelujah, by night, praying and calling upon the name of God. There are still people, hallelujah, who put their trust in God. And God said, give it to the priest. The tabernacle, give it to the priest, hallelujah, that the sons of Zadok are being sanctified because they are the only people, hallelujah, who keep my charge. Hallelujah, they did not went astray. Even their colleagues went astray. They did not went astray. Hallelujah, even the whole nation went astray. Oh, hallelujah. In these last days, what we need is to stay put, stay where you are. Praise God in your faith to the Lord. Stay where you are. Hallelujah. Even in your right side, hallelujah, there are problems. In your left side, there is pandemic. Everywhere there is difficulties. Hallelujah. But I tell you, church, stay where you are. Hallelujah. You just continue to keep the charge. Praise God. That is why God said, I invite you all to that meeting point. Hallelujah. In this ungodly time, come. We will settle this at once. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. During the time of Isaiah, there were so many priests who left their ministry. Same today, there are many pastors who left their ministry. Hallelujah, and gone and backslid. Hallelujah. This was a writing in the book of Malachi. And now, O ye priest, this commandment is for you. Para sa aming mga pastor, para sa aming mga ngaral, pero hindi lang po ito sa amin. This is not just for us as the office, praise God, hallelujah, of being a pastor or a priest. Because everyone that is baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, hallelujah, you are a royal priesthood. Ang bawat isa sa atin, pari, mga kapatid, by the virtue of the blood and by the virtue of the Holy Ghost that was being given to us. Listen to me carefully. This is the commandment. And God said, if ye will not hear and if ye will not lay it to heart, hallelujah, if ye will just take it for granted to give glory unto my name, saith the Lord of hosts, I will even send a curse upon you and I will curse your blessings. Yea, I have cursed them already because ye did not lay it to the heart. Hallelujah, the Levite, the priest of the Levites, praise God, the priesthood that belongs to the tribe of Levites was being cursed. The blessing was already given, but their blessings was cursed. And God said, do you know why? Because they did not lay it to their heart. Hallelujah, that is why I'm calling, hallelujah, to all the preachers around the world. Hallelujah, to all coordinators, leaders, hallelujah. Praise God to all believers in the name of Jesus. Put it in your heart. Do not take it for granted. When we already meet the Lord at that meeting point, He already forgive your sins. He already cleansed you. He already written your name in the book of life. Hallelujah. Put it into your heart. Put into your heart. Did you hear me? Let us put it into our heart to live a holy life. Let us put it into our heart to trust Him. Praise God. Because if we will not put it into our heart, if we will just take it for granted, praise God, this calling, God said, I already curse the blessing that I have sent to you. Oh, yeah, karahos satalari, karabahas satalaye, yarahaye. Lord, we want your blessing. We don't want the curse. God, help us to put these things into our heart. God, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. I am calling to all New Life Fellowship saints. I am calling to all, hallelujah, my brethren in the Lord. Let us put that message in the heart. Do not take it for granted. Hallelujah. Isaiah called them citizens of these wicked cities. Even their feasts were an abomination to the Lord. Nevertheless, listen to me. Nevertheless, hallelujah, God keep inviting them to come and to be clean at that meeting point. If we will always come to that meeting point in the presence of God, you will be clean. You will be clean. The third that I'm going to share to you is this. It was an invitation to that meeting point for cleansing at a sinful time. Hallelujah. I repeat it again if you are jotting your notes. Actually, you can review this. Invitation to reason at an unreasonable time. Invitation from God during ungodly time. And the last, praise God, that I'm going to share to you this morning is, this is an invitation to that meeting point. An invitation for cleansing at a sinful time. This is an invitation to be forgiven. This is an invitation to be sealed by the power of the Holy Ghost. From scarlet red to white as snow. From crimson red, hallelujah, to white as wool. Praise God. Do you know that in the New Testament, it is always, praise God, a desire. It is already in the heart of our Lord Jesus Christ. To anybody who desired to be clean. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. What was Jesus' response? And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will. Jesus didn't say, do something so that I will be convinced that you are, praise God, so that I can heal. No, Jesus without, praise God, without thinking for a moment, praise God, or choice, he said, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. The nature of the Messiah, the nature of our Christ, the nature of our God, hallelujah, his desire is that all his people will be clean. Hallelujah. Look at the record in Mark chapter 1 verse 40. And there came a leper to him, beseeching him, kneeling down to him. Oh, hallelujah. And saying unto him, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. What did Jesus do? And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him and said unto him, I will be thou clean. If you can just reach that meeting point, God is willing, hallelujah, to cleanse you. God is willing to touch you, hallelujah, because he have great compassion. His compassion is great. His mercies are new every morning. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus, blessed be the name of the Lord. This is the cry, hallelujah, of David. He said, purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Purge me with hyssop. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. God meets sinners where they are. Hallelujah. When sinners will reach the meeting point and cleanses them. God is still calling to the unreasonable people, hallelujah, to the ungodly people, hallelujah, in this sinful time, he will forgive and cleanse all who will come unto him. Praise God, I tell you, church, his blood still, praise God, makes guilty ones clean. Did you hear me? His blood still has the power to make the guilty ones clean. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, the message is still the same. The meeting point is, praise God, when a man will repent. And now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter answered and said to them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. I tell you, church, that the blood is powerful. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. The meeting point, hallelujah, is not difficult to find, because the moment you confess your sins, the moment, praise God, that you repented, hallelujah, he will cleanse us all. And God said, come, let us settle this at once in this meeting point. Revelation chapter 1 verse 5 tells us, and from Jesus Christ, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us and washed us from sins, from our sins, in his own blood. It was the blood of Jesus. Oh, there's power in the blood of Jesus. Come to that meeting point. God invited you. Isn't it reasonable to respond to his call? Praise God. Isn't it reasonable? Hallelujah. To respond to his call. Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is what the Bible said. Repent ye therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing, hallelujah, shall come from the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. And God commanded people everywhere to repent. At the times of this ignorance, God winked at, but now commanded all men everywhere to repent, because repentance is the meeting point. Come to that meeting point. Hallelujah. Because the moment you bow down, the moment you confess your sins, God said, oh, hallelujah, I will cleanse you. I will forgive you. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I go back to what I have told you earlier in the introductory part. Hallelujah. That when the North and the South Korean leaders meet at the peace house, at that meeting point in the demilitarized zone, they both raised their hands. All the media network of the world, praise God, give a very nice title of their news. There was clapping, there was joy. But that is only a man-made, praise God, man-made covenant, man-made, praise God, declaration. But I want to get a picture with you. With man and God will meet at the meeting point and reason together. When you raise your hands, God will also raise his hand to grab your hand. Both of you will raise your hand. I'm telling you this morning, you may be alone in your place. I am alone here, New Life. I am alone here, praise God. I close the doors so that no one can disturb me. But I tell you, church, I feel the presence of God. Hallelujah. Right now, praise God, come into the presence of God. Would you just please, hallelujah, open your mouth, praise God, right now. Would you just please, hallelujah, praise God, close your eyes for a moment and let us go at the meeting point. Hallelujah. Praise God, we have no meeting now in the church physically. We have no meeting here, hallelujah, at the church. Maybe you already missed the picture at my background, praise God, hallelujah. Maybe you already missed this altar, hallelujah. Maybe some of you are missing this altar, praise God. Maybe for some reason others will just stand at my back, praise God, for picture taking to become the profile of their IFB picture. But I will tell you, church, praise God, right now, even though we have no physical meeting, but we can still come at the meeting point of repentance, hallelujah, and still receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. We can still feel his holy presence. Come on, stop now, praise God, writing in the comments. Please, stop right now writing in the comments. Hallelujah. Focus at the meeting point. Focus. Let us come, praise God, to the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I'm going to pray with you right now. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, bless your people right now, worshiping you in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord, I declare peace and joy. You are the treasure. Ikaw, Panginoon, ang totoong treasure sa aming buhay. Hindi ang mundo, hindi, Panginoon, ang mga bagay. Panginoon, lalapit kami, Panginoon, ngayong lahat, Panginoon. Kaming lahat lalapit ngayon, praise God, sa iyong presensya, kahit mag hiwalay-hiwalay kami. In the name of Jesus, in the name of the Lord, I pray. Praise God, touch your people. Touch your people. From this pulpit, from this place, I declare blessing in your life. I declare peace in your family. I declare, hallelujah, blessing, praise God. Oh, revival in your spirit. Kahit wala tayong meeting, we can still meet the presence of God. There is a spiritual meeting point right now. Come on, grab the hand of your friend right now. Hallelujah, and pray together. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.